So one of the more common questions that I get asked for mobile photographers who are looking to streamline their photo management workflows using Lightroom Mobile is, what's the best way to import your photos into Lightroom Mobile? Now, fortunately, we do have a few options when it comes to getting your photos from your phone's camera roll into Lightroom Mobile, but it really depends on your preference and how you plan to use Lightroom. Now, when it comes to this particular video, I'm going to run with the assumption that you are a mobile-first or mobile-only photographer. In other words, you use your iPhone or your Android device as your camera all of the time or most of the time, and you want to establish a workflow to manage your photos using Lightroom Mobile, either entirely or in tandem with your camera roll. In some cases, the workflow will sound pretty straightforward, but I also want to show you my own personal approach to managing photos in Lightroom when all I take is my iPhone. So with that, let's dive in. All right, so here we are in Lightroom Mobile on my iPhone 16 Pro Max, and really everything I show you should work pretty much the same regardless of which smartphone you're using. I'm an iPhone user, so that's what I know and that's what I can show you. But for the most part, I would say that there are three primary ways or three methods to managing your photos using Lightroom Mobile, and it really depends on what you want to do. So this first method I call the 100% manual approach. And what this means is you will have full control over which photos go into Lightroom. And you can do that one of two ways. You can either just go to your Photos app, and then you can just choose, like I can hit select here, and I can choose a certain number of photos, and then I can tap on the share icon here, and then go to Lightroom, and I can import it that way. That is one way. So again, you are 100% selecting which photos from your camera roll go into Lightroom. The other way in terms of the 100% manual option is you can go into Lightroom here. You can go to the device tab on the bottom left. And then here, if I go to my newest images, just like in the camera roll, I can go into this select mode. And then you can see on the bottom left, there is an import option. Now, in terms of the 100% manual approach, I actually prefer doing it this way by starting in the device tab as opposed to the camera roll. And here's why. Because when I tap on import here, I have two options. I can either import it directly into Lightroom, or I can import and add to a Lightroom album, which is one of my favorite things. I manage all of my photos in albums, and I like this little option here where if I tap this, you can see I can go into my photo library. I can go down to 2025, go into January, and then I can create a new album here and add those photos. So I'll do that really quickly. I'm going to tap on the plus over here, create an album, and I'm just going to call this manual import. I'll tap OK. You can see the album's created and it's already selected, and I'm going to tap on import. And now those three images are going to be imported in. And so if I go to the Lightroom tab over here, I tap on the dropdown to browse. Let's go to Photo Library, 2025, January. And there you can see are the three images that have been imported. Not only are they imported, but they are also being synced to the cloud, which you can see here. Those three images are being uploaded. Nice thing about that is they're synced in the cloud along with the edits that I make, but they're also backed up. So what does that mean? Well, what I can do now is I can swipe up over here, go to Photos, and then I can select those three images that I just imported into Lightroom, and I can delete them because there's no reason to have two copies. And that's something that's important to me. Like, I like to be as, I would say, clean as possible with my photos. And so I don't need to have these kinds of images in multiple locations. If I have them in Lightroom, then they're in Lightroom and I don't need them in my camera roll. And so I'll go back and delete them. And so that's something that I want you to keep in mind as well. All right, let's move on to the second approach. And this is the 100% automatic approach. So this is the opposite, as you can imagine. First one was manual, this one's automatic. This is basically you saying, I know for a fact that I just want all of the photos I take to be imported into Lightroom. I don't want to have to think about it. Now, fortunately, it's really easy to configure this. What you'll want to do is either tap on the Lightroom icon on the top left over here, which brings you to app settings, or you can tap on the ellipsis on the top right, and then at the very bottom, there's app settings. Then we're going to tap on import, and you can see on the top here, we have the option to auto add from device photos. Now, here's what's great about it. It's a granular setting, meaning you can choose to import your photos, your screenshots, and your videos. Now, I don't want screenshots in Lightroom, 100% no, I don't need that. And I also don't manage video in my Lightroom library. That is just kind of a personal preference. If you want your videos there, then you can enable it. But for me, I only store my photos. And here's the other thing about me. I actually kind of fork which service manages my photos based on the nature of the photo. So all of my personal photos, like the photos that I take of my family, holidays, those kinds of things, those are 100% managed in iCloud, in the Photos app with my iPhone and my Mac. The reason for that is I usually will share those photos. I have plenty of family shared albums. And so it's just a lot easier because everyone in my family has iPhones to just create shared albums and share it with them that way. As opposed to, I don't know, other than I think my wife, I don't think anyone has an Adobe ID. So it would be a little bit more difficult. You could do it, certainly. But for me, it's just easier to have the personal stuff in Apple Photos. It might be Google Photos for you. But then all of my serious photography, in air quotes, the stuff that where I actually take my phone or my camera and I'm out taking photos, those are 100% managed in Lightroom. So here, the 100% automatic method, as you can imagine, is I just turn this on over here. And now, going forward, all of the photos that I take with any of the camera apps, those images will be imported. Now, that's a really important point. This works from the moment you turn that switch on. It won't just take your images from the beginning of time and import them into Lightroom. You'll start automatically importing into Lightroom all of your photos from the moment you turn that on. So watch, if I swipe up and I go down, I'm just gonna launch the camera. And so you can see there's my office and I'm just gonna take a few quick photos. Now, when I go into Lightroom, those photos will automatically import in. So watch, I'm gonna launch Lightroom over here. Now you won't see anything because they're not importing into this album, which I created. You could see manual import. They're going back here. If you go to imports, you can see just how those three images just popped in. And so there they are, they're imported in. And now what I can do is I can manually add those images into an album if I want. And that is how I work. You might just have everything in a flat, you know, all photos view, but I like to store my photos in their own albums. So what I would have to do here is tap and hold on these. You can also just tap on the entire day right there, the entire import session. Then tap on add to on the bottom left. We'll go to photo library, back to 2025, January, and we'll put it in manual import and tap add. And so now I've basically organized those files, but remember, I didn't have to do any of those imports. I just brought them in and then I manually put them into an album. Now, just like before, remember, I don't want these in the camera roll, and that's an important point. These photos, you can see, are in the camera roll on the bottom right. They are the newest photos and they're in Lightroom. So just like before, I'm gonna tap on select those three images and delete them because they're just not necessary. Now, the third and final way is my personal approach. It's a hybrid between auto import and manual, so to speak. When I know that I'm going out on a shoot with my phone, for example, or even if it's my phone and my camera, but I know that I'll be using my phone on that shoot, this is exactly what I do. And I love this workflow. Basically, what I'll do is I'll go to Lightroom, and before I do anything, I'll go to my photo library, 2025, January, and I'll create the album for that shoot. So today is January 12th. I'm gonna create a new album, and I'll call this 2025-01-12, and I'll just call this backyard bird shoot. And I'll tap okay. So now all of the photos that I want to take from this moment forward, I want them to go into this album. So how can I do that? Well, this is a really awesome little known option. If you tap on the ellipsis to the right of the album that you just created, or any album, you'll see a switch here for the option Auto Add from Device Photos. I'm going to turn this on, and you'll see here, from now on, new device photos will be added to this album, so I'm going to tap on Enable. You'll also see that right below the album name, there is the album count, but also there is this little notice that this album is being used for auto import. Now, as you can imagine, there's only one album that you can use at a time for auto import. Like, watch, if I go to manual import and I enable this, you'll see the same dialog box come up. I'll tap enable, and now that manual import will get the new images. So again, I created the album for the shoot of the day. Let's go ahead and we'll enable that. And now let's say I just go ahead and I go on my shoot. So let's go ahead again. Let's go to the camera app. And just like before, we'll just take some photos. And now I'm going to launch Lightroom. You'll see here that those images are being brought into the album automatically. I didn't have to do anything. If I go into the album, there are the three photos. And if I tap on the cloud, those images are being synced to the cloud, which is great because they will be backed up again along with my edits. And just like before, again, because they're in Lightroom, I'm going to go to the Photos app here. There are those three images. I'll tap on Select, and I will delete them. Now, here's the most important point, because until you take this next action, you will still have the auto import enabled for that album, which I don't want. This is a very intentional thing that I do. So now that my shoot is done, let's pretend that we got home. You know, we're tired, we're hungry, but we're really satisfied because we got some great photos. And those photos have been imported into Lightroom. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Lightroom here. I'm going to tap on the Lightroom app icon, go to import, and I'm going to turn off auto import photos. Now what happens here is if I go to the album, you'll see that it no longer says auto import. And just kind of to really seal things up here, again, under import, you can see how photos is disabled. But if I go to the album again and I enable auto add and I tap on enable, that will automatically enable that option under import. You can see how photos is enabled. That's just kind of, they go hand in hand. You can't obviously have the auto import for album enabled without this option enabled. So when you're done, all you need to do is go here to the import section of the app settings, turn that off, and going forward, when you take photos, they won't automatically import. And so that is, again, how I manage my mobile photos with Lightroom. I use this all the time because I know in advance, usually, that I'm going on a shoot. If I don't, then I'll quickly launch Lightroom and I'll create an album in the respective year and month, and then I'll just turn on auto import because I don't want to have to think about it. Now, remember, an important point is that the photos won't auto import in the background. You have to launch Lightroom. So you go ahead, you do all your shooting. You don't have to kind of worry yourself about what's going on. Just take care of your photography with your phone and with your camera. And then when you have a break or you're just done, just launch Lightroom. Usually what I'll do with my phone is I'll connect it to some sort of a power source or a battery, and I'll just let the import happen. And as that's happening, Lightroom will start syncing the photos to the cloud. There is this option here, though, if you want to pause syncing while import is happening. If you tap on the Lightroom icon and you go to import, at the bottom here, you'll see there's this option to pause sync while importing. I do have that enabled. So basically, the import will happen. No syncing to the cloud will happen until that is complete. And then once that's done, it'll start syncing to the cloud. Otherwise, it'll just start syncing as photos import. So it's totally up to you. But again, you have the options of either 100% manual, you choose which photos you want to go into Lightroom from your camera roll or from the device tab. You have 100% automatic, where as you take photos, they're just being brought into your all photos view. And then you can manually sort them in the album of your choice. Or then there's the hybrid, which is what I use, where I create the album, I turn on auto sync for that album ad hoc, and then I let the photos sync into that album directly and then turn it off when I'm done. So just something that has been on my task list of videos to create, because I get this question quite often. And now I'm happy that it's out there because I can point people to it. Now, with that, I do have a course. I mention this all the time because I am so passionate about it. Lightroom Mobile is just one part of the Lightroom Cloud ecosystem in addition to Lightroom Desktop and Lightroom Web. And if you want to learn everything there is to know about it, please check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. It's got over 10 hours of easy-paced lessons. It'll teach you everything you need to know about the entire ecosystem of Lightroom's cloud apps. Now, speaking of Lightroom Mobile, I have this video here if you want to learn all about the new features and improvements that were added to the most recent update. So check that out. And of course, if you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is always appreciated. It really does help the channel. And please be sure to click on the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.